How lonely is it to be in this industry? Is it symptomatic of the industry or is it symptomatic of Karan, who hasn't resolved all his issues internally?
Well, I've resolved all my issues internally.
You have?
I have.
So why do you say you're sleepless at times?
Because you feel lonely.
Scared,
I think the industry per se should not be generalized for the reason of your loneliness. But you really wonder about how many of your relationships matter and how many don't. Sometimes the lines are very blurred in our industry, Barkha. We're insular people. We live in this bubble all the time. Because we talk film, we sleep film, we eat film, we just...
And
then you build relationships, you build emotions, and then you don't know if those emotions are really those that just are up for the film, or then will you take those even when you don't work together? So you land up wondering about every equation you make in the movie industry. And then at 44, when you're lonely or not in a relationship, you wonder, I don't want to grow alone, I don't have kids. You wonder that, you know, what your life is going to be and all the success you might get and all the love and attention you get, where does that go? Because you have to take it somewhere. When you don't have that love to share with somebody, it gets you worried. And it's a recent kind of an anxiety that I have... I've discovered about myself, and I've read people talking openly about their depression, and there was a phase in my life where I was really depressed, and I went through that phase and I thought it was something to do with me getting a cardiac arrest at one point of time, and I went to my GP.
Were there panic attacks?
Yeah, and he said, you're going through an anxiety attack.
The symptoms are very similar, because I know the first time I had a panic attack, I actually thought I was having a heart attack.
Exactly. So I remember rushing and I didn't tell anyone. I just felt it. I was in the middle of a meeting 2.5 years ago. I left. I just said, sorry, I have to leave. There's something urgent come up. And I went straight driving, because I'd heard that Saif Ali Khan had felt something similar once. And went to, ironically, the same GP, Dr. Agarwal. He's the popular GP of most people in the movies. I went to him and he says, it's an anxiety attack. And I met a psychologist post that. And then I realized that I had to deal with some internal issues that had not built up and reached to this point. That was resulting in this anxiety.
Deepika Padukone on my program first came out about actually being recognized and diagnosed with clinical depression, and then she said it's really important to speak about it publicly. Are you saying you went through something similar?
Well, she told me, the psychologist, she said, you're going through depression, and as a result of that depression there's anxiety. There's no particular reason for it, because it wasn't...
It can be chemical.
It was, and then I went through a series of medication for it.
Antidepression medication?
It was anti-anxiety at that time. A year and a half post that, when I stopped that, I realized that, you know, I was in a much better place. Like today I actually feel the emotion of excitement and happiness. There was an entire zone, and I don't want to sound like this poor little rich kid, like a kid, well, not at all, but like, you know, but it was genuinely, only you know when you're going through it what you feel. Like you stop feeling the zing, you stop feeling excitement, you stop feeling happiness, you know, and now I feel like those beats are coming back in my life.
And how would it manifest itself apart from panic attacks?
Lack of sleep, always on the edge, basically just directionless, and you feel always like you need to take a beat to breathe, like, you know, you feel like it's reaching, like, you know, and you feel lost, like I was leaving even social events and parties much earlier than I would have. I wasn't there, like, and I used to wonder what I was going through till I started those sessions. Made a big difference to me, because I felt that in those sessions we touched on many things of my life, many things that actually I had parked. You know, catharsis, you know, also even the fact that I had not dealt entirely with the loss of my father, though it's been 11 or 12 years. I felt the pain and hurt of certain relationships that had dwindled from my life. And I was carrying all that baggage and the fear of the future. The fear that I wasn't being able to find a life partner. Though I was being able to vicariously live through my cinema, I wasn't actually being able to feel that presence of love and laughter in my life. At one point, it was really bothering me. Today, I feel a lot more free of it. I feel the abandon. I feel like the so what. It's not there. There are many other things to look forward to.
It's brave of you to share it, and I say that because there's a certain degree of condescending, lack of understanding when people talk about anxiety attacks, when people talk about depression. People don't understand that it is an ailment. They think if you're rich and famous and have this cushy existence that Karan Johar does, how dare he be depressed?
He has no right to be.
I don't agree with that.
No, and I really believe that I think in the days of urban angst, which is what I think we feel constantly in the zone that we live in, we're surrounded with so much noise. That used to not be our life 2 decades ago. This noise of social media, this noise of over communication, this noise around us all the time. And I think it's because of all that noise, you crave that silence. And I think that when you don't have that silence, there are other kind of, you know, it manifests into other things. Like now when I look back, I feel I've seen older people go through it and we've never been able to diagnose it. Like I felt there was a phase in my father's life where I felt that he probably could have gone through depression and we kept feeling that he's become introverted all of a sudden. And I felt that had me and my mother really taken it up more seriously, because we would have understood it probably better then. We didn't. Today when I look back and I feel like there are so many people that we just think dwindle into silence and into their zone, and we think, you know, abhi thode, you know, buzurg ho gaye hain to unko chhod do, you know, but actually they're going through a lot. It's a disease. It can happen to you while, you know, you're doing absolutely nothing with your life. You can be in a marriage, all sorted with your kids, everything, and you could find yourself depressed. Like Deepika Padukone was very brave to speak about it. She's gorgeous. She's stunning. She's successful. Why is she depressed? What do you mean? Like, I have a friend, like, who's a very pragmatic friend, Manish Malhotra, and he was like, don't talk nonsense. Like, he's like, why are you depressed? He's one of those people who doesn't understand this. But when I went through it, it was the most dark period of my life. I can't explain to you the pain and anxiety and anguish. And
what did you feel? Like, describe what you felt.
Helpless, unhappy, sad, wanting to get onto a flight and always leaving the city and walking the streets of other cities with nothing to say to anyone. Not getting out of my bed from my hotel room sometimes, and I wasn't being able to share this with anyone. I was making up meetings and reasons for me to leave the city. I found comfort in sleeping on a long haul flight, waking up in a city where I didn't have to meet people, and being in my hotel room till 3 and 4 till I really got out to have lunch or just walk the streets with my thoughts. It was a very dark, deep and a helpless time. I mean, there was nothing I could do about it. But I passed because I was medicated, Barkha. I went through psychology, and there's a difference between going to a therapist and a psychologist. I needed medication.
It wasn't just counseling. You actually needed psychiatric intervention.
I did need it. And when we spoke, and you know, sometimes the psychologist is a blend of therapy and psychology. And
it's always both.
This lady kind of brought the two schools of thought together and realized that she had to put me onto immediate medication. So first it was like much stronger, and then we weaned it off. And it's just 3 months ago that I actually stopped it all. And I feel like I'm in touch with her. She's a friend. And when my movie was, my trailer came out, and she chatted, and she says, your film looks happy, and I'm happy.
Well, thank you for sharing it.